shower blessings on the Prophet, O ye who believe, ask blessings on him and salute him with a worthy salutation. Messenger, Allah hath cursed them in the world and the hereafter, and hath prepared for them the doom of the disdained. And those who malign believing men and believing women undeservedly, they bear the guilt of slander and manifest sin.
صدق الله العظيم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. الحمد لله برادر أنيس was able actually for this video recording or YouTube recording to actually incorporate into it both the text that I write for the presentation and the slides. So sometime when you speak, you misspeak, you say a wrong word that, you know, in the wrong time, and then so you can correct it basically. You can read the text or you look at the slides. Another point which I want to emphasize and have emphasized before, whatever I present here, if you are convinced with it and you want to share it, feel free to share it with anybody, including the text, including the presentation, but it will be yours. It is no longer mine. So if you are convinced with it, use it and claim it yours. If you are not convinced with what I say, then in this case, you know, don't worry about it. You don't have to tell anybody, but don't be convinced with an idea different than mine and go say, oh, you know, this is the right one, Brother Mamdouh said this. No. You know, if you want to tell people, tell them right one. If the right one is my idea, it is yours and you can share it. It becomes yours in this case. So just to make it clear this way to avoid, you know, people coming and say, oh, you said this and try to argue with me. No, I present to you what I feel comfortable with. And you should present what you feel comfortable with. And what I present to you is what I have learned from so many people that I do not give them credit. Because frankly, this is the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not copyrighted. You know, the verses in the Quran, the hadith, it's not, nobody copyright these. You cannot really make money or take credit for it. So, many of you actually have liked the method I used before, which me serving as a graduate student, and you serve as professors. So inshallah today, we are going to follow the same format. I present my thesis to you to address three questions. This is the thesis topic. What is the ultimate dua? What is the ultimate supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Where is the best location to make it? When is the perfect time for making this ultimate dua? This is my thesis topics, actually, what I'm going to address in this presentation. Now, so what I need you to concentrate, because at the end, you are going to vote whether I passed or I have to go back and rework the thesis. So please, you know, when you're ready to vote, be sure that you're voting out of knowledge. Don't daydream and interpret what I say wrong. So to address this question, I'm going to follow the scientific methodology that I have mentioned before. And this methodology is attributed to the Muslim, you know, scientist and scholar, which Abu Ali al-Hasan ibn al-Haytham. And his name, actually, it's well known in Europe that he is the father of the scientific methodology, and his name in English, al-Hazen. So if you search it, you can find. And this methodology involve six steps. What he says, he said, the first of all, when you see something, you make an observation, then you think a question, then you formulate a hypothesis, then you develop some predictions, then you collect data to test, you know, the validity of the hypothesis, and then based on that, you make judgment whether the hypothesis was correct or you want to modify it. So that's what I'm going to address this. So the first one, I'm going to make an observation. I said, when we perform the salah, you know, we notice that we greet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the end of it, not at the beginning. And we greet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we're sitting down to do the tashahud. Because what the tashahud start with? At-tahiyyatu lillah was-salawatu tayyibat. You're basically saying at the end, all greeting to Allah and the prayers and the good deeds. So we don't do that in the beginning. We do it at the end, actually, in the salah. So, but this is contrary to what we do in common practice. In common practice, if I'm going to go meet somebody important, what do you start with? You start with by greeting him first. You don't, you know, start talking to him about a lot of other things and then say, Assalamu alaikum. But obviously we cannot say Assalamu alaikum to Allah because Allah is Salam. So the form of the tahiyyat to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the form of greeting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to say At-tahiyyatu lillah wa salawatu tabat. This is how we greet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when to relate to the common practice that we do, if I want to meet somebody to seek some support from help or support from him or help, what is the process I go through mentally? First of all, I make arrangement for the time and the place to meet him, and this will be the time and the place of his choice. It's not the time and place of my choice, time and place of his choice. Then the second one, when I meet him, I start by greeting him, and then after this, I can make the request. You know, you might give some gratitude to him or something, but the end of the day, you are going to make the request. And when you make the request, you don't want to spend half an hour making the request. What you do, you in advance, you actually select the concise words you are going to say to represent the request that you want. So this is the normal practice. So when we can look at this and say, okay, so this is observations, you know, then I will look and say, raise some question. I said, what type of arrangement I need to make for meeting Allah? And then what are the best time and the place to meet Allah? And the third one, what words I should use to greet Allah? And the fourth one, what is the one request that I should make that can cover all my other requests? So these are the four questions that, you know, I want to think about and see how can I address it in this regard. The third step in this scientific methodology is to make a hypothesis. So I start answering the question before collecting the data, make an assumptions in this case. So which would be actually the answer, the end of the presentation, I want to ask you, did I verify these requests? Did I validate these requests or not? So here is how I'm going to formulate the hypothesis that I have. I said the best arrangement we can make to meet Allah is to perform ablution and enter into prayer. And perform the salah or perform the prayer in the format that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have identified for us. So this one, this is what Allah selected, the way to do it, the time you are going to meet him. Then the best place you are going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obviously it is going to be in the house of Allah, in the masjid. But any other place, if you are not accessible, if the masjid is not easy accessible to you, then any place will be fine. But obviously the best place is the masjid, to come to perform the prayer in the masjid. Beyond, what is the best time? Beyond the obligatory prayer, the best time is the last third part of the night. So if you, so basically I'm saying, if you really want to meet Allah and make request other than the obligatory, other than the time of the obligatory prayer, it's the best is the last third, you know, part of the night. The best place, position in the prayer to make the dua when you are sitting down for the tashahud. And then the proper words that I should use to do the dua that encompass everything I need, the request that I satisfy everything I need, the greeting, the proper greeting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when I said the location is the prayer, the time, sorry, the time is the prayer, the position is when I'm sitting, starting the tashahud, the greeting is at-tahiyyatu lillah wa salawatu tayyibat. Now, the ultimate dua, and this is the question I'm trying to do, because that's really the most probably important, you know, one. The ultimate dua that will encompass all our needs, encompass, cover all what I want, or all of the words that I want to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala request from Him, is Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. Allahumma barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. So that is the ultimate dua, which is, we can translate it, O Allah, pray on Muhammad and his family as you have prayed on Ibrahim and his family and the family of Ibrahim. Grant favor to Muhammad and the member of his household or his family as you granted favor to members to Ibrahim and the household of Ibrahim. You know, so then I'm going to say, okay, how I'm going to prove this? You know, I'm going to prove by saying there are clear verses in the Quran and the clear authentic hadith that will confirm my hypothesis. So now I have to go and start collecting the data to test, you know, these hypotheses or this prediction I made. We said that the after the obligatory prayer, praying at night is the most important act of worship, and the present is the best prayer you will ever make. Prayer at night is better than praying during the day, especially in the last one third of the night, you know. And also the best time to make supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also in the last one third of the night. So where is this? How can I prove this? Then we look the hadith, and I was looking only, you know, I'm picking a hadith now. Obviously there's so many of them, so I'm trying to pick the ones that, you know, that what you call most authentic, that is reported in both Bukhari and Muslim. So there is a hadith reported in both Bukhari and Muslim on Abi Huraira, who when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and you see the Arabic, I'm going to read the English, our Lord, may He be pleased, blessed and exalted, descends to the lowest heaven every night when the last third of the night is left. So the hadith says that Allah descends to the lowest heaven the last third of the night. And He says, you know, who will call upon me that I answer him? Who will ask me that I may give him? Who will ask me for forgiveness that I may forgive him? So the hadith basically saying that the last third of the night, when this is a time when you want to ask Allah for something, Allah will give. You ask for forgiveness, Allah will grant you the forgiveness. You know, you want to call Him for something, Allah will answer you. So that is the hadith emphasized this. And this hadith actually also emphasized by another hadith, which is reported by Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, in which he says, the dearest prayer to Allah is the prayer of Dawood, the Prophet Dawood, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He used to sleep for half of the night, gets up and pray for 1/3 of it and sleeps for 1/6 of it, and he used to fast a day and one day and not the next. So basically saying that the best, Sayyidina Dawood, the best prayer is the prayer of Dawood, and the prayer of Dawood was 1/3 of the night. Now, when we make this hypothesis, we said, okay, now it is, you know, I said the best dua is to say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin. First of all, you know, no, let me start first. How are you going to greet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Well, I said, the greeting for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I say, attahiyatu lillahi wa salawat ta'ibat. So where are we get this from, you know? And this is a hadith also reported by Ibn Mas'ud and reported in both al-Bukhari and Muslim, and I'm translating the word that al-Bukhari says. He said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when one of you prays, he should say, all attahiyatu lillah wa salawatu tayyibat assalamu alaykum, the first part of the tahiyyat. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam telling, when you pray, you should say this, which is when you pray, you should say all greeting to Allah and the prayers and the good deeds, peace upon you, O Prophet, and mercy of Allah and his blessing, peace on us and on the righteous servant of Allah. I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad is his servant and messenger. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, after you say this, then ثم لا يتخير من الدعاء أعجبه إليه فيدعو به. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, after you do this, then select from the dua the most wondrous dua and make a dua with it. So after you do the first part of the tahiyyat, what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after you say this, and we say this during the tashahud, when we're sitting, then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam pick the best dua you want to make and make it. Then the question is, what is the best dua that we can make? And I made the hypothesis that this dua is Allah, you know, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Muhammad. I just said that's the best dua you will ever make. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, after you do the first part of the tashahud, you know, basically greeting of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the first part of the tashahud, you should do the best dua you want to say. So how, and I said the best dua, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Muhammad, kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. So the question is, what is this, you know, what is the proof that this is the best dua? First of all, you know, doing the salah on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad, is command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is not, you know, a choice, is not something we select. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Ahzab, Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala al-Nabi, Allah and his angel pray on the Prophet, Ya ayyuhal ladhina aman, O you who believe, sallu alayhi wa sallimu tasliman, pray on him and invoke peace upon him in abundance, you know, most frequently. So now, okay, with the command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but how would I know that is a dua? You know, then we look to a hadith that reported by also by Bukhari and Muslim, and reported by Abdullah ibn Abi Layla, and Abdurrahman ibn Abi Layla said that Ka'b ibn Ujra came to him and told him, should I give you a gift? I heard from the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, yes. You know, he said, you know, we said to the Messenger of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, Allah ordered us to pray. Then how are we going to pray for you? Because the command is pray in Allahumma alaikum sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu alayhi. How do we do the prayer of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Muhammad, kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, innahu hamidun majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad, kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, innahu hamidun majid. This is the form that most commonly written. There is other hadith that, you know, have a little bit smaller deviation on it, but the same, you know, context is the same. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was saying, how you do prayer on the Prophet by saying this. Still the question is, okay, we understand that this is how we're going to do it, but how would I know that this is a dua? That is, you know, the question. Then we go to a hadith by Ubay ibn Ka'b. Ubay ibn Ka'b came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, O Messenger of Allah, I pray on you often. And here is the prayer, and I'm going to address that issue of prayer, because the prayer is a dua. What he actually, when you read the translation, most of the translation for it, he said, you know, inni uksiru salata alayk. And then when people translated always, they said, I made more a frequent dua or supplication to you, for you. So he said, not to you, for you, because obviously you do the dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but for somebody. So he said, I pray on you often. So how much of my supplication, how much of my dua I should devote to you? And he said, as you desire. He said, should I devote 1/4 of it? And he said, as you desire, but if you were to increase upon it, this will be better for you. So Ubay ibn Ka'b said, can I make half of my dua to you? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, and he said, as you desire, and if you were to increase upon it, it will be better for you. Then Ubay asked again, can I make 2/3 of the dua for you? And Ubay ibn Ka'b say, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam answered, as you desire, but if you were to increase this, it would be better for you. Then Ubay ibn Ka'b finally, he said, can I dedicate all my dua for you? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, then all your needs will be satisfied and all your sins will be forgiven. So we understood that the dua, when you say Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim, is a dua. If you make it, then all your sins have been forgiven and your needs have fulfilled. So what do you need more than this? You can sit down and say, Allah, I need this, I need this, and I need this. But you don't know sometimes know what you need actually is good for you or not good for you. So if you make the dua, this Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad, then in that case, your Allah, you know, Allah will give you the needs that you want that benefit you and forgive your sins. Then there is an addition. There is also another hadith in Muslim an Abdullah ibn Amr, who said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, man salla alayya salatan sallallahu alayhi ashra, whoever prays on me one prayer, Allah will pray on him 10 times. And when Allah prays, that means Allah forgives and blesses. So you just say Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad, and then Allah subhanahu makes salah on you 10 times, and the salah of Allah is blessings from him and the forgiveness from him. So in that case, there is no way you can achieve anything else other than this. And if you do this, you know, in this regard, you will find Allah. Obviously, we know that, you know, you do it out of the love of the Prophet ﷺ, because now you dedicated your prayers or your dua to the Prophet ﷺ, and the Prophet ﷺ said, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده وولده وناس مجمعين. You don't believe unless I become more beloved to you than your parents, your children, and all the people. So in this regard, if you dedicate all your dua to the Prophet, Allah directed this dua toward you, and in this case you become, you know, the most, you show your, that you are a true believer, because you show, express your true love to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So now the question for you is, did I, you know, prove the element of my hypothesis or my thesis that the best position of the prayer is to make the dua when you're sitting down for the shahud, and the proper words to do the greeting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tahiyyatu lillah wa salawatu tayyibat, and the best dua is Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, Allahumma barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. You know, obviously You know, there is other forms of dua which is also reported that the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam made. But, you know, I'm saying this is the best dua. This is the ultimate dua that encompasses all of the things. But even when you make it some at the prayer, even if when you say it in the prayer, you can do your special dua. But ensure at least that you start with this dua first and then do the other ones, you know, in this regard. That is why that the tashahhud is so important, actually. You know, sometimes we say it so quickly, and we don't, you know, know what it says, but it is one of the most important act of, obviously reading the Fatiha is the most important, but this is also the most important act in your prayer. So now, if you object, if you think that I failed to, and you know, to address or at least to prove my hypothesis, raise your hand. Alhamdulillah, nobody raised his hand, so the approval is, there is some descendants, but he is abstaining, you know. So, alhamdulillah, I passed by, you know, by unanimous vote, thank you very much, but, so your vote is so the best, and you can sign after this. But now there is actually, now before I finish and do the dua, I want to actually raise, you can ask me later about some question, but I'm struggling with something, and I think even when Justice Shahzadu comes here and makes some presentation of the Quran and language analysis and so on, it is, it really, you know, raises a question that sometimes we overlook. And this is how we translate the words of the Quran. You know, like some, like I was, like look at the word, for example, Salah. You know, we said, إِلَّا اللَّهُمَ لَكَ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ. How am I going to translate the word Salah? You know, should I translate the word Salah as prayer on the Prophet? Should I translate the word, and the people actually have translated the Salah that as blessing on the Prophet? Or I should translate the Salah, link it to the root, which is Silah, means a connection. So I translated for the word, or I translated for what is the meaning of it. And that is becoming a big issue, because you know, you can read a translation and you read another translation, but you can come with a third translation. Everybody, if unless you translate the word for word, and sometimes it's difficult because sometimes the Arabic language, you know, has the word that cannot be translated directly. So you translate the meaning of it, your understanding of it, the intention of it. Well, in that case, this is a proper translation or not? Do you translate the thought on this process? That is an issue that we always have to struggle with when you look to any translation. But the question also comes to say, how did Allah translate? You know, how did Allah translate? Because if you look in the Quran, you find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speak about communication by other people who never spoke Arabic. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, وَقَالَ فِرْعَوْنَ, that the Pharaoh said this, Pharaoh doesn't speak Arabic. وَقَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ, Ibrahim didn't speak Arabic, Prophet Ibrahim. How about Lut? قَالَ لُوت, قَالَ قَوْمُ لُوت, the people of Lut, they didn't speak Arabic. So obviously they spoke in a language. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala translated this, put it in Arabic words. So in a way, translation. Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala translated what they intended to say, all translated the word? So that is an issue that we have to, you know, to think about it. And frankly, that brought in my mind a very interesting question. And I wish, you know, student who's going to, you know, college, they actually might, this might be a subject for a study. How we speak, how we hear, you know, like when I speak to you now, what happened? There is a sound wave that go from me to your ear. And the sound wave get pulsed, you get vibration in your ear, and the vibration get transferred to an electrical signal, and the electrical signal go to your brain, and the brain interpret what I said. First of all, are all of you received the same vibration? received and your ear translated the same electrical signal. And therefore the brain interpret what I said in a way, you know, what I said or what I intended to say. The second part, when I speak, how my tongue or my mouth moves. First of all, the thought comes to the mind. The thought gets translated into an electrical signal that moves toward through the nerves to my mouth, and my tongue and my mouth moves with the words. Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have directly did not look to what they said, but looked to this signal, the electrical signal that passes from their brain, and that will be the words they use? And that raises a question. If you speak Arabic, I speak English, and want to say the same thing, would the signal be the same or would it be different? And therefore, if the signal is the same, then it doesn't matter what language you have, the signal will be the same. And Allahu A'lam, I don't know the answer for this. In fact, I have been looking and searching, you know, to see if there is papers or anything on it, how you do it. Because if you do it, if somehow it is the same, and you can create a device to pick the signal from your brain, I will directly know everything you are thinking of. And obviously Allah subhanahu knows everything you are thinking of, even if we do not say it. So that's a question actually to come, and therefore, but the fundamental part to us is when you translate from Arabic to English, do you translate a word, or you translate the meaning, or you translate the intention? And in this case, whose intention, who is interpreting the intention in the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I'll finish with this one, and then we can raise question after this. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Allahumma hadina fi man hadaytu wa afina fi man afaytu wa tawallana fi man tawallaytu wa barik Allahumma lana fi ma a'taytu. وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت إنك يا ربنا تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك. اللهم ادخلنا برحمتك في عبادك الصالحين. اللهم اخرجنا من ظلمات الجهل والوهم إلى نور العلم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما. اللهم بفضلك ورحمتك على كلمة الحق والدين. اللهم انصر الإسلام وعز المسلمين يا أكرم الأكرمين. أو الله spread your mercy upon us, shower us with your blessing, increase our knowledge, grant us forgiveness, and reward us with the company of the prophets in the Firdaus al-A'la. O Allah, purify our heart, strengthen our faith, increase our knowledge, and make us benefit from what you have taught us. O Allah, forgive our parents and all the believers, and grant them the Firdaus al-A'la. O Allah, remedy our sick, and grant them speedy and full recovery. O Allah, guide our children, protect them, and make them righteous. O Allah, guide us to always be a source of peace and security for all people. O Allah, guide our fellow citizens to the truth and open their hearts to Islam. O Allah, we ask with every name you have elected for yourself in this blessed hour that none of us leave this gathering, but his pains have been relieved, his worries have been removed, his debts have been paid, his weaknesses have been concealed, his sins have been forgiven, and his needs have been fulfilled. سبحان الله وبحمده عدد خلقه ورضا نفسه وزنة عرشه ومداد كلماته سبحان الله وبحمده عدد خلقه ورضا نفسه وزنة عرشه ومداد كلماته سبحان الله وبحمده عدد خلقه ورضا نفسه وزنة عرشه ومداد كلماته والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على خير المرسلين اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وسلم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته وجزاكم الله خيرا for listening and passing